guys, Luke Swanson from Living the Dream Guide Service. Today we are going to tie a musky brush, which is a huge part of the pig sticker, which we will go over in another video. But the pig sticker is a big musky fly that you can build from 12 to 20 inches. And this brush has a big part of it and takes up most of the fly. And it makes, you know, an 18, 20 inch fly super quick to tie that has big profile, pushes a lot of water, and catches a ton of fish. So this is a key component in it. And we're going to start off with 10 pound Power Pro. So we're just going to pull a little bit off. You're just going to do a quick overhand knot with that. Then you're going to hook it to the side with the drill on there. Hook it to the other side. We're just going to spin this on here. And we'll set it up top. So we got our base on there. Then we're going to use Wopsy Premium Dubbing Wax. You'll just get a nice good coat on there. Don't use too much so it globs up, but just enough so it'll be tacky. So do that. Trim our tag on there. I'm going to lift the board then all the way up. So, today we're going to be using white and olive bucktail for starters. And with this, you're just going to take a big chunk of bucktail off, pull out the smaller tag ends, throw it off to the side, and you're going to set it on. And with that, you're going to spread it out. The key with putting it on and spreading it out is less is more. If you get too much on there, when you go to spin it, it's going to get all bunched up. And so when you first start doing that, that might happen, and I'll kind of talk through that once we start spinning it up. So you're just going to keep laying it on there. Don't worry about how much space is from here to the tag end or here to the tips of the fibers. We're just going to spread it all out. So on the brush here, we're going to keep this side more white, and this side has more olive. And what's cool about a brush is you can use 3-4 different colors, and it's all going to blend together how you put it. So you can just wrap it on the musky fly, and you already have that taper of the color you're looking for. So we're going to move to olive here. I'm going to put olive up front. Spread that out. Olives is going to be in front, but I'm actually going to put it on top of the white and then spread it out so it goes from that white to dark olive taper. So we're going to chop a little bit more up olive. We're going to spread it out down in the back as well. So you can do this with any color, any bucktail. If you want it long, short, in between, totally up for you depending on what size of musk you fly. You're looking to big and build and how much profile you're after. So I think we're looking pretty good on that. It's all pretty evenly spaced out, as you can see. And here, you can spin it up from here. But what I've found is the deer hair sticks really far up, almost straight up and down, when you go to wrap it on the shank or the hook or whatever you're wrapping it on. And so I like to add a little bit of SF blend. And it comes in a package, SF blend. Comes in a big package like this. I like to take just a chunk out, about half of a width of a pencil, a little bit less, just like that, and I'm going to fold it over in half, just like that, and then I'm going to cut it. So then I kind of fan out all the fibers in my hand here, and then I'm just going to pull a group off like this and set it in. You don't want big chunks, you want it kind of loosely everywhere. Same thing as bucktail, less is more. But you just want a little coating on top of this SF blend. And That'll keep those fibers of the deer hair down and push them down a little bit. And so you get more of a side-to-side swimming action instead of pushing a ton of water. Which it'll still push a ton of water, as you can see in the pig sticker video that will be linked down below once it is available. But now we got all that on there, nice evenly spaced out. And that's basically it there. From here, I'm going to take Power Pro, I'm going to add some more wax onto it. All the way down, all the way up. Got a little bit of it. Then you're going to hook it up to hook on the other side. Tighten it down. So when you get to the hook here, you're going to spin it down on top of the knot, and then you're going to spin it back. And then just trim it up. So from here we're going to drop this, and you can see our butt ends are going to still be standing up here. So we're going to push these guys down. You don't want more than a half of an inch. And when you're pushing them down like this, you're looking at the bucktail end. That SF blend is still going to be sticking up farther, and we'll come back and trim that here in a minute. About a quarter to a half an inch. That looks pretty good. And so we got a little bit more sticking up. So I'm just going to trim this up of that SF blend that's been sticking out. Get it trimmed up to how you like. Make sure it's still even, because you might get clumps. If there's too much bucktail, you're going to get clumps in it. And that's where problems come in. And I'll show you that here in a minute. So, start spinning it up. So as we're spinning, this is looking really good. I got a kind of a clump here and a bigger clump right here. So with that clump, I'm just going to kind of reposition it. Try to even it out more so that can get spun around. Sometimes, like this one's got a lot right here. I'm just going to pull that out a little bit. Give it a little bit more room. And keep spinning. So here now, we got a nice brush, and you're just going to pull the excess fibers out. And just like that, you got a nice bucktail brush. From here, I'm just going to use some regular old super glue. Stick a little bit on one end on the braid, do a little bit on the other. And all you have to do now is trim it. Cut it off each end, and then you'll wrap it on the shank, the hook, whatever you're looking to wrap it on. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hopefully this helps in your next musky bug. It makes it quicker, easier, faster, and you can keep your next musky fly completely consistent. You make this much brush, and you can figure out how much each shank needs. And once you figure out what swimming motion you want, you know how much that is, or how much deer hair you have. So you can consistently build bugs, musky bugs, pike bugs, smallmouth, whatever you're looking for. You can change the length. We do smallmouth brushes that are much shorter, you know, 1.5, 2 inches instead of the 3 or 4 inches big, or even 5 or 6, depending on what length deer hair you have. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.